Good morning, Yellow Faculty.
Good morning.
I'm very pleased to be here to speak with you this morning for this assembly. I'm going to begin the assembly by asking you if you know the four following men. First name is on screen. Does anyone know who that is? Freddie Mercury. Yes.
He was in a band, Queen.
He certainly was. He was in a band called Queen. In the 1980s, he was widely considered to be part of the biggest pop and rock band in the world. He was a UK citizen, but he was born in Zanzibar. That's a picture of him on stage at Wembley in front of 80,000 people. And he was very, very, very well known and died about 20 years ago. I'm not sure that anybody would know this name, but any hands that do? Well, sir, Alec Issigonis was a very, very famous designer, and he designed cars. He designed a whole range of cars, and his most famous one is appearing on screen now, the Mini. And that car is known the whole world over. He was a UK citizen who was born in Turkey. Any artists here might know this name, Sir Anish Kapoor. And he is widely regarded as one of, if not the greatest, living sculptor in the world. And he has designed very many large installations and structures, including the one there beside the Olympic Stadium, the Orbit Tower. And he is a UK citizen, but he was born in India. And finally, Michael Marx, not a name known to many people, but along with Mr. Spence, he was responsible for starting what is now the UK's most popular, busiest high street store, Marks and Spencer's. And he was a UK citizen, but he himself, with his family, came from Russia. He was Jewish, and he had to escape Jewish persecution in Russia. And what do all of these people have in common? Well, they're from refugee families. And a refugee is somebody who has to leave their own country for a variety of reasons, and they need to leave their country and go to another country where they can live the rest of their life. I'm going to show you now a British Red Cross video from 2011. And they put this together to highlight some of the issues that refugees face and why they need to leave their countries. Thank you. we've seen in that video why people need to leave their countries. They need to escape war, or famine, or floods. They need to escape ethnic cleansing and human rights abuses and political persecution. So when there is no food, these people need somewhere to go, or they die. When there's ethnic cleansing, they need to get out of there quick. Ethnic cleansing is when one religious group sets about killing or trying to exterminate another religious group, slaughtering people, men, women, and children, because they have a different belief. And it's not right that people should have to put up with that. Refugee comes from the word refuge. And refuge means a safe place, something or someone to go to for assistance or security. It's a shelter from danger or hardship. Now, those people who need to leave their countries, they need a safe place, and for them, that's a new country. For us, I would suggest we even need our own safe places in our own daily lives, but we're the lucky ones. We have lives which can be, from time to time, very busy. They can be stressful a little bit. So we need to have our own safety and our own refuge. And I asked a few members of staff, four of them in fact, what was their refuge? What does safety and a safe place mean for them? We videotaped it, and this is what they had to say.
Refuge to me is many different places. My first place would be when I'm dancing. It's my refuge away from people. My second place would be when I'm in my bedroom at home, because I've got my lovely sheets all around me. My third place would probably be in food acting base, where if I have a problem, I can go and talk to my friends about it.
As a history teacher, when I think of the word refuge, it makes me think of the Second World War, and then later on the Cold War, where the government asked people to create a refuge in their house. So, for example, during the Blitz in the Second World War, people would build a safe place to go in the middle of their house, usually underneath the stairs. And then later on, when the country was at threat of nuclear war, the same kind of instruction was issued, and people were told how to build a safe place, a refuge in their house, which is where they would go if there was a warning of attack. So that's what refuge means to me.
My refuge is my sisters. I go and visit them whenever I need to de-stress and talk things through. They help me.
Okay, I have two refuges. My first one is really obvious because I'm an English teacher, so I read a lot. So if I really want to get things off my mind, I can lose myself in a book. And my second one, if I'm particularly upset, is I turn to my iPod and I listen to my music. There's certain bands that couldn't always pick my mood up, so I can lose myself in that.
I too have safe places. That's a picture of my nieces and nephew from a few years ago. And one of the things I love to do is to go and spend time with them. They're in Ireland, and one of the best things in my life is being able to switch off from day-to-day living and go and get to play with them and just to hang out and to have a little bit of fun. And that helps me just to take my mind off things and to escape for a little bit. And another very safe place for me, very important place, is my back garden, which you can see on the screen. And I love just going out there and potting around, doing a little bit of work, and it's a place where I can escape. A very, very important place for me, in the corner of that garden, you can see there, that little shed. That's a very important place in my life. It's been a source of many a party and a very happy night, but it's also a place where I go to read. By myself, big mug of tea, just go, shut myself away from the noise of life, and sit there and read. And sometimes I don't read, sometimes I'm just sitting there thinking or listening to the sound of the wind or the rain. And that's important to me, it works for me. And as you grow older, I would encourage you to find your own safe places. Find something to do, find a place to go and to be where you're able to just think and just to sort things out in your head. It's very, very important. But we're the lucky ones. We're able to do that. Refugees who have to leave their own countries, they face far, far worse situations, and they have turmoil. And we're talking about it this week because it is National Refugee Week, with the theme of different pasts and a shared future. And it's a UK-wide programme of arts, cultural and education events that celebrate the contribution that refugees make to our country and to our communities. And this assembly is an example of one of those things that we're doing. Now, refugees come to us from far and wide. The latest statistics that we have are from the year 2010, and they're appearing on screen just now. You'll see that, and these are average numbers, about 1,500 refugees from Afghanistan, about 500 refugees from Sudan, almost 2,000 from Iran, 500 so from Somalia, and 1,500 or so from Zimbabwe. And those are just a few of the countries that refugees come to us from. And it's important, in my opinion, that we offer a safe place for those people, especially today. The pictures that are appearing on screen now are just from the last few months in a country called Syria. And you may have heard in the news or read in the papers about the terrible civil war which is happening in that country. And those are pictures there on the top left of teenagers who are out fighting because there's nothing else for them to do. Their homes in the middle picture have been destroyed. Bombs are regularly being dropped on towns, cities and villages. That's a child who's been very badly injured in the bottom left picture. And that's a mass grave in the middle at the bottom. Dead men, women and children because of a terrible, terrible war. And there's almost 2 million refugees in the last 2 years from Syria alone. I think it's important that we reach out to those people and say, you can be safe with us. And that's what we do in this community. In our academy, we are a safe place. You only have to look around this room to see the huge, wide variety of skin tones that we have in our community. We have people from all over the planet here. Whether you're first generation UK, second generation, third generation, immigrant or refugee, we are a wonderful mix of people. And that's what makes us strong. The fact that we have so many people, that we can learn from each other, that we can respect each other and our values. And I thought it was important for us in this assembly, in this Refugee Week, to hear directly from one of our own refugees, Montazer Ali in year 11, who left last week. Very kindly, before he went, did a piece to camera so that you could hear about his experience as a refugee. And this is what he had to say.
Hi, my name is Montazer Ali and I've just finished year 11 at Harris Academy in Morden. 3 years ago in Afghanistan when I was with my family, I was so happy, but now I feel that because when I was in Afghanistan, I used to hate them because I didn't have my choices and I couldn't go to school because of the war going in Afghanistan. But when you are 12, you have to go and kind of join the Taliban to fight the Americans. And my mom didn't want me to do that because she was quite afraid that I might die or I might do something bad. So she decided that I have to leave the country. And I left the country, but it was hard for me leaving my family when I was 13, leaving my family and my brothers and my kind of village. And then I arrived to London. I didn't know the language, I didn't know the culture, I didn't have no one in London. And it was really hard for me. Then they gave me to foster parents. It was kind of for father and mother, like your parents. So it was, then they kind of helped me to learn the language and learn the culture. Then they put me in the school and then I learned the language more and I found out that it is good for me that whatever is going on in London. And now I feel that I'm really blessed that I'm in London because whatever I want to do, whatever I can do, I do that. Because when I was in Afghanistan, I didn't have no choices. So, and now and in the future, I feel that I will be a good person and I will try to help the country and the people that are near to me. And ever helped me. So thank you very much and try to help people.
Some of you are 12. Could you imagine having to go out, take up a gun, and start go fighting? That's what he was faced with. He doesn't say it in that clip, but he admits he doesn't think he'd be alive if he stayed in Afghanistan. And he thinks he would be dead. Or Montezer thinks he would be dead. And that's not good. We wouldn't have had such a remarkable young man in our community. We wouldn't have had such a remarkable leader in our community. And it's so important that we think of that. How lucky we are that we can have people here, give them a place of safety, make them part of our community, and together go forward. And I come back to the theme for this week of the different pasts and the shared future. Together, from each other, with mutual respect, we can become an outstanding community that's inclusive for everybody. And I'd like you please to think a little about that this week when you're completing the tutor competition. You're going to have a choice of questions. What does refuge mean for you, and what is your personal refuge, and why is it important to you? And do you think it is important that the UK is a place of refuge? Explain why. I look forward to reading what you have to say, and prizes, as always, will be awarded in the next assemblies. We're a very, very lucky bunch. We've got good lives, although some of our lives may from day to day face their own struggles. But we don't have to deal with a fraction of what some of these refugees have to go through. I think it's very important that we remember how fortunate we are, and I think it's important that we do everything that we can to build an inclusive community and together become outstanding. Thank you very much for listening.